All right, Angela and I are in my country number 50, her country number 9, in San Marino. And what's really cool about San Marino is it's the oldest country in the world. Confirmed. Apparently it was like inaugurated in like 301, the year of 301. and it's the oldest constitution in the world too. They made their constitution in the year 1600. It's really clean here, right? Really clean, really medieval feeling. What do you think, Angela?
Yes,
yeah?
Very medieval.
What are your first impressions of San Marino in the evening?
Lots of hills, like, it's lots of walking.
She does not do very well with all the walking.
I'm okay with walking.
It's not uphills?
Yeah, not uphills.
Angela and I have arrived at San Marino, and as is tradition, one of the first things we gotta do when we get to a country is find something to eat, right? And so we are here. Where is here? We're at a place called Giulietti KMO. Angela got this Titan brow, which is as big as her head. You'll have to tell me how this all is, babe. Because I can't drink the alcohol anymore. You have to drink it for me. The alcohol of every country. It's not a bad deal, right? This is your first try of San Marino beer.
It's really good.
Describe it.
It's fruity.
It's a fruity beer.
It's a fruity beer.
Huh. Can I smell? It smells like beer.
Yeah. More sweet.
It's sweeter. Angela and I ordered this small appetizer for about like 8 euros, so this is hefty. This is super cool. So Angela ordered her pizza, but I mean, yeah, so I was reading on San Marino, they're really into the like thin bread. Similarly, I got like this little sandwich, and they wrapped it in the same bread here. And I got like tomato and like ham and arugula and cheese in here. This is pretty dope. I mean, despite it being a bit strange, how does it taste, babe? Solid. It is really good, but it's weird.
Doesn't feel like a pizza.
Mm.
It's a pita bread.
But it's still really good pita bread.
Yeah.
Awesome. Oh, I wasn't recording this whole time. So you keep mentioning something about the air in San Marino.
I'm not gonna repeat myself.
What the fuck? God damn it.
Had one shot, babe. We blew it.
Well, Angela keeps remarking about how fresh the mountain air is up here in San Marino. And it's kind of cool. It's got, we're in a mountainous region, but like, got kind of this like bouldery, rocky vibe kind of going on. It's like a really clean, medieval feeling, don't you think?
Yes. I wonder, the country's like, kind of small.
The country's,
size, right?
Country's kind of small in size, yeah.
Why am I on camera?
Well, I want to hear what your thought is. So you're wondering, the country's kind of small in size, right?
Yeah.
There's about 33,000 people who live in this country.
Uh-huh.
So what are you curious about?
33,000 people.
Uh-huh.
I wonder what their occupation is.
San Marino, apparently, like, one of the number one things is that they do finance here.
Finance here?
Mm-hmm. And a lot of these small countries, I don't know about San Marino in particular, but a lot of these small countries are like tax havens, right? There's not too many people here.
Not too many people.
Yeah. So, Angela and I are hiking quite a bit, and it's uphill. Lot, but it's really pretty, right?
Mm-hmm.
But Angela's tired. Well, there's like the 3 points of San Marino, and so we saw two. There's this final one right up over there, which has a bit of a secluded hike to get there, but we're not going to do that. It's pretty astounding, though, just to, like, see on one side of the mountain is just this, like, sheer fall into this ominous valley. All right, San Marino is over. So we're on our way out of San Marino. It's really difficult to get into this country, apparently. There's no planes that come in here. There's no trains that come in here. You have to take the bus, which we didn't really see any buses anywhere. And so I think really one of the most reasonable ways to get into San Marino is by car. And so we ended up renting a car. And it's not that expensive. It's like $20 a day plus a full tank of gas. And and the drive is pretty nice as well. So, final thoughts of San Marino. It's very quiet here. It's very pretty. And we stayed kind of in like the medieval castle side of things. I feel like you could probably spend 2 to 3 days here, right? We didn't have enough time. We only spent one day here. And so we didn't go and tour around the castles. And like we were gonna buy like tickets to go in there. But the guide insisted that we need at least 2 days. And if we wanted to drive around like the countryside a little bit more, we probably could have taken an extra day for that. Mm-hmm. So like, what would you recommend for people coming over here? How many days? Two, three days?
2 days max.
2 days max?
Yeah.
What are your thoughts of San Marino, babe?
Oh, it's pretty.
It's very pretty.
Very old.
Very old. Well, it is the oldest country in the world.
Very old.
Uh-huh.
But it's nice.
It's very clean.
Very medieval.
Very medieval.
You get manly.
Manly?
Manly city. It's like
I thought it was like proper, like princesses would like live here and stuff.
What?
Yeah, like defend the princess.
Princess castles are like rugged. It's pretty. It's supposed to be.
The food. Well, so the food here was particularly interesting because we ordered pizza and they almost served it on this like flat little pita bread thing. And what did you think of that?
Weird. It was like it was weird, especially because the sauce was kind of watered down.
Oh, yeah, used
like tomato. But cheese was good.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you very much, San Marino. Gracias. Te bella. And until next time. Bye.
Bye. La pioggia scenderà, d'improvviso succede.